Hey Kyle, it's Richard. I found some more good examples in Loving County for that frac hit study.
Hey Richard. Okay, great. Yeah, what'd you find out?
So I've been going through and tagging the frac hits as either positive, negative, or neutral. So if you go into the project, you can see what I mean.
Okay, cool. So I've got this project pulled up and I'll search for frac hits. And I can see that you've been tagging some of these as neutral, positive, and then a few negatives. Was it the Lindsay pad or the Kudu pad that you wanted to look at?
Yeah, let's look at that Kudu pad.
Okay. I can click into this and looks like it's taking us to the frac kit summary page. And I can see the Kudu pad has one parent well and three children.
Yeah, and you can see here the production of the parent well, once those child wells come online in 2019, you know, never goes back to that same level of production.
Yeah, I see that it was making about 550 barrels per day before the shut-in, and then after the wells came online, the oil production was around 160, 170, so pretty significant degradation there.
Yeah, and then if you look on the gun barrel diagram, you can get an idea for what the spacing pattern is for these wells. Some of the other pairs that we've talked about were, you know, centered on vertical interference. But this Kudu pad, this is all about horizontal well-to-well interference.
Yeah, and it even looks like the operator tried to space these child wells 600 to 800 feet away for the closest two. And then the third one, which is even the best producer, is about 1,000 feet away.
No, and that makes sense that there's not a pressure sink and those two wells aren't competing for the same resources.
Yeah, and it does look like there's even other wells adjacent to this child well. If we look at the map, there's some more wells to the west that we could even dig into and look at their performance.
Yeah, so the next step I'd like to take here is to really quantify the impact to that parent well so we can really understand sort of what the cash impact is, but also what the reserves impact going to be to these parent wells.
Sure, that makes perfect sense because if we fit a new decline curve segment after the frac hit, it's never going to come back to the trend that we see before these child wells came online. So I think next we can update the decline curve and then run that through an economic scenario to see what the EUR and NPV impact of this frac hit actually was.
Yeah, that sounds perfect. That really appreciate your help.
Sure. Looking forward to it.
Talk soon.